It's sure a nice day for a walk, and you might not know it, but there's a vast aquifer filled with clean water right under my feet. Welcome to Protecting the Source, an educational video series about how each of us can protect our vital drinking water from pollution. I'm your host, Jim Eakins, University of Idaho Extension Water Educator. In this episode, let's take a closer look at Idaho's aquifers, the main source of drinking water for most of Idaho's population.
An aquifer is an underground source of water that exists within gaps or cracks in rocks and interstitial spaces among unconsolidated materials like sand. Groundwater refers to any water that exists underground, but aquifers are special in that they provide enough water flow for commercial and municipal uses. It's not an underground river or lake, but instead water that exists, sometimes flowing, among tiny gaps underground. Many areas of Idaho have aquifers. Most cities and many rural households have one or more wells to pump up water from small local aquifers. There are three specific aquifers in Idaho that are of special importance. These three sole source aquifers are the sole or principal source of drinking water for an area and therefore is afforded special protection. It's important to protect all of our groundwater. Septic systems, animal waste, various chemicals from farming, commercial and industrial facilities, and natural occurring chemicals can contaminate well water. So can some surface activities like applying fertilizers and pesticides and petroleum products dripping from our cars. High levels of contamination can put private well users' health at risk. Private well owners are encouraged to test their wells to ensure their water is safe to use. The Spokane Valley Rathdrum Prairie Aquifer is a critical sole source of drinking water for almost 600,000 people in the Greater Coeur d'Alene and Spokane region. It was formed by a series of massive Ice Age glacial floods, the Lake Missoula floods. These flooding events filled the ancient southern valley of the Purcell Trench between the Selkirk and Coeur d'Alene Mountains with hundreds of feet of unconsolidated sand, gravels, and boulders. The groundwater flows faster through the aquifer than almost any aquifer in the world. However, it's unconfined and therefore extremely susceptible to pollution from the surface. The Lewiston Basin Aquifer, previously called the Russell Aquifer, was designated a sole source aquifer in 1988. The aquifer provides all domestic water to Clarkston, Washington, and the greater Lewiston areas in Idaho. This aquifer exists as gaps and cracks within several basalt rock formations. Each layer of basalt holds water within pores and cracks. Three formations contain aquifers within the Lewiston Basin: the Saddle Mountains, the Wanapum, and the Grand Ronde. Each formation is separated by sedimentary deposits that confine and isolate each layer of the aquifer. The Eastern Snake River Plain Aquifer underlies much of southeastern Idaho, from Ashton to Hagerman. It is Idaho's largest basalt aquifer, covering an area approximately 10,800 square miles. In addition to average irrigation and drinking water withdrawals of 2,670 cubic feet per second, the aquifer provides 7,800 cubic feet per second to the Snake River at two sections of the river. Water flows among layers of basalt and other sediments. It, too, is mostly an unconfined aquifer and therefore rather susceptible to pollution seeping in from the surface. Aquifers are a hidden resource that we heavily rely on. We need to protect them as our most often used source of drinking water. And remember, there's more information and other resources available at protectthesource.org and University of Idaho Extension Water Publications. There's a whole lot more to the stories of Idaho's aquifers. Contact your local Extension County office to get connected to more local aquifer information.